Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Late Night Valhalla, 20th of December. Oh, nah, yes, okay. First things first. Because I myself was distracted, I didn't prevent Jill from being distracted. So we have... I had to deal with that as I was recording the two episodes for today. At one point I also was so distracted that I decided to record the second part for today, the video, again! But I saw a cute dog, which is nice. Which is the silver lining for today and my day. So... I can't complain. Dogs are wonderful creatures. Anyway, not what I wanted to talk about today. Rather ramble. We all know how this will go. It will devolve into a ramble and I'll possibly forget what I tried to say and everything just falls apart. Basically, the usual. Welcome to my channel. But hopefully, today, it won't happen that much. Because I want to talk about something I already talked about. I'm rehashing content of my channel. But I will hopefully not go off track, like right now. B, it may help someone. Again, it's about writing. But it's not about my writing. No. Oh yes, it's another mention. Another thing I should mention. Those long pauses. The long pauses in the dialogue there. It's basically me being distracted. I did two things at once. Not just what I normally do, for example, listen to a video on my laptop or do something else rather menial. No. This time I was writing and talking to someone. So keep that in mind. Lock me up right now! So, the thing I want to talk about. Short stories! Yay! First and foremost, this is aimed at everybody who wants to begin writing. Or more specifically, writing stories. Because if it's just writing, there a whole lot of things you can do in that regard. Articles, satire, the mentioned short stories, novels, theater, what else? Already mentioned articles. brave lord. Poems. For some reason I couldn't get those in my mind. Maybe because I'm not a poet. Cheers, by the way. Breakfast juice. Which contains apple, grape, orange, and carrot. According to this bottle, just orange and carrots. So, if you want to start writing and want to tell a story, I highly recommend starting with short stories. And there's a reason. Not because they are short. No. For example, let's take one encounter in Valhalla. And there we also have the connection to the video. Perfect. Oh, hello, Archiva. How's it going? Distractions. Directions everywhere. Where was I? Ah, yes. Let's take, for example, Kim. Kim is good. So, remember the first day of the main game where Dana brought Kim in? That's a perfect short story, right there. Because we just... A? Okay, it's of course short. But more specifically, there aren't a lot of actors. There's only Jill, Kim, Dana, and by extension, none of the doors. Just these four. It's a rather small cast. So, property number one. Property number two. Short stories have more properties than just being short. Property number two. Generally, we just jump in. We don't really have a beginning or an end. It's just like Dana brought someone in and here we are. Don't know why, we don't know how. And boom, situation is here. You could say, okay, Dana bringing Kim into the bar. That's a beginning. As I mentioned, we don't know why that happened. We don't know how that situation occurred. And don't we know how it ends? In Kim's case, for now. Because, spoilers, she will be here again. Okay. Then we have pumpkin. Today we are mentioning pumpkin. So we don't know what it means after she went out of the box. So the short story of the kin here is basically how she basically ended up where she is right now. How she feels, so on and so forth. It's basically Kim winding down a bit, and he explaining how this all happened without mentioning that she almost did the biggest mistake you can ever make. Cheers. She tells us why she's the augmented eye, how the work there is, how she feels about it. But we just get that as well. Still no real beginning or end. We don't know how exactly she wound up there. Don't completely know how, for example, every day was, what happened every bloody day. Just get an overview, which can cause a real poverty of short stories, my situation. We don't get the specifics, just, I don't know, what, one of the actors tells to the other. In this case, what Kim tells Jill. So, it's also another thing. Another example I can get. Short stories are... Okay, it's visualizes. Yes, getting in front of your TV, smile at night, you're zapping through the channels. It's advertisement, 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 advertisement. Boom, boom, boom. Let's stick to it. You watch it. 5, 10, 15 minutes. Until the next advertisement comes, and then you say, oh, for crying out loud. Let's switch channels. That again could be considered a short story, because you absolutely don't know what the movie is doing of this movie. You will not know what happened in the end, but that's not in the way you zap in. You jump just directly in. With just a handful of actors, at best, they usually just pull you one through. Then, yeah, that's your short story. Okay. What happened to her is basically a whole novel of survival horror game. Pick your poison. But back to short stories. Those are the properties. They are A, of course, short. They only have at best 100 actors. They don't have a clear beginning or end. And if they do have, then it's literally just one incident, one situation. That's it. they are not necessarily that specific. You could also say they are just a small window for a small time into the life of your character. You could also just go to the window, look out for 10-15 minutes and just watch what happens. Or go to the park, sit on a bench, and watch people for 10-15 minutes. It's also a short story. And if you want to write stories and are a beginner, don't go big. Go small at first. Practice. Pick a direction. By direction I mean a character, a situation, and go. And here's the thing, short stories can also be bloody good. H.P. Lovecraft, for example, Dagon. I would say that is a short story. You only have this one incident, where the writer of confession slash suicide note basically writes down what happened to him, why he's the way he is right now, and then let's just say he had an intimate meeting with the floor. That short story has a definitive end. But not to the beginning. I don't know anything about the person who wrote that note before that, before this incident. Don't know his life, don't know his name. What we know is basically he was once a prisoner, a German warship during the Great War. Woke up on a weird island and madness ensues. Madness that drives him to drug and later on to said intimate meeting with the floor. And for a short story, that is bloody long. But still, nonetheless. I can't wish that I did buy the bloody shoulder message on you. Because we missed something here. Lost my train of thought, and even with the littlest direction I got. Wow! And I didn't even need notes. because luckily that's something I already talked about. Anyway, break time. See you later.